Hey, what's up, guys? This video here is the Smith & Wesson 386 Night Guard range video. I'm finally being able to take this thing to the range. Lately it's been tough for me to get to the range, but I want to get this out there, do a test fire functionality test, make sure everything's A-okay, so that I know we're good to go with this. So, sometimes when you guys get new acquisitions, it's just sometimes kind of cool just to late at night, you're watching, whatever, TV or a movie. I was watching TJ Hooker, actually. And you just like to look over safely now. You want to be safe about this because I just heard of a incident with a negligent discharge that happened to somebody. But well, we won't get into that. But being safe, you like to fondle and look over your latest acquisition. Just, check it out. And on this one here, pretty much it looks like it's a new condition, except for one thing on the top strap over here, which I'll show you in a second, what I noticed. But pretty much it's in like new condition, and having that previous owner's receipt in the case, kind of reinforced my feeling about this revolver. He only got it back in November 11th, 2011, and I picked this thing up in March 31st, 2012, I believe that was the date. So the guy didn't really own it that long, and he did pay a pretty big price tag on this thing, and I was able to get this at a pretty low, price, which I'm still surprised and happy about. So I guess I shouldn't complain, but the only imperfection that I really noticed on this revolver here, and let me show it to you, is on the top strap, and it's right there. As you can see, it's a chip, if you can see that. And I don't know what that's from. Some people at the gun shop that I show this to, a different gun shop, not where I bought it from, but they said it looks like someone used a screwdriver to clean carbon off that area, and they basically chipped the metal right off there. I don't know if that, if you think that's what happened, but I guess they've seen this kind of damage, minor damage before, from people using jewelry screwdrivers to scrape carbon off that area. And I've gotten PMs about people saying, well, the night guard suffers from flame cutting and all this other stuff, but I don't see any evidence of that here. And my J frame, the 340 M&P, I've shot 357 Magnum through that. There's no evidence of any flame cutting or any kind of damage. There's wear right in front of the forcing cone, whatever, but there's no flame cutting happening. And I believe that is just some kind of, maybe the previous owner was trying to clean it and he chipped that like that. But you guys let me know what you think of that. I'm going to take it to the range and see what happens. But I'm not too worried about that, I guess. All right, so I'm going to be heading off to the range shortly, but I just kind of want to address some few things. I'll be doing a separate video about this other stuff here that I get PMs about. A lot of people are saying, like, what's up with the revolvers here, why aren't you carrying 1911 or an M&P or a Glock? Revolvers are old, antiquated, slow, blah blah blah. And I don't know, I already kind of did a video about that, but it seems like a lot of people are just curious of why I'm carrying a wheel gun now, and I'll get into that in another video. All right, guys, let's go head off to the shop to pick up some ammo first. All right, I just actually left this I don't want to say they're a store, they're not really a store, but I was very impressed because I asked to see if they had this stuff here. Short barrel version? Yeah, I've been looking for this everywhere. No shops around here carry it. So these guys actually had a bunch of it, and I didn't want to buy a lot of it just yet, but I bought two boxes of it. I'm gonna go to the range now, test fire it through, maybe like, I don't know, just a few rounds through the J frame and through my night guard, just to see how it feels. I've heard a lot of good things about the gold dot short barrel version, so we'll see how it works. And also bought some of this stuff here. I don't know if you can see it. That's a pretty inexpensive target ammo, but it's pretty hot for being target ammo. So all right, well, let's get to the range. Let's check out, see how this stuff works. Thank you. All right, just left the range, and it was a successful range visit, a very pleasant one. I was very satisfied with the range today. The 386 Night Guard did fantastic. Everything works. Very, very easy to handle, guys. Recoil is so manageable with that end frame. Or is it an L frame? Sorry, it's an L frame. Those grips really dampen the recoil, even with the 357 Magnums. It's no problem. It's almost like shooting a 1911. But I shot my 340 M&P, the J frame, and there's a drastic difference. The J frame bites, hurts when you shoot it, especially with 357 Magnum. Now I want to show you this. These are the two 357 Magnum rounds I use, which is this right here. I'm a believer now, man. This stuff right here is what I'm going to be using to carry in my night guard, at least. This stuff here, the PDX one, it's like the 41 Magnum. The stuff was like, the muzzle flash was horrendous. It was extremely loud, and the recoil was very punchy. So you could feel the concussion of the, the round going off. This one right here was very, very manageable through the night guard. Through the J frame, it's very, very similar to the 38 Special Plus P 110 grain. I was putting them side by side in the cylinder, and I could almost not tell the difference between this stuff and the DPX 38 Special. So I guess I'm gonna have to check out the specs of the Gold Dots short barrel versus the DPX 38 Special. I don't know, it's kind of weird. It's like, I'm just curious if they're like, because the short barrel, I mean, maybe it's loaded a lot less, a lot less and stuff, because there was not much muzzle flash, as you can see through the video I'm going to edit. So, and the other thing was, I was trying to take a lot of video today, but unfortunately I wasn't able to, because there was a lot of people at the range, and because I kind of got interrupted by somebody. A guy two ports down came up to me, and he was very, very curious about my night guard, and kind of wanted to look at it. I let him shoot a cylinder of seven rounds, and he had a 1911. I think he had a Dan Wesson. I don't know what model it was. I'm assuming it's the Valor, and he let me shoot seven rounds out of his Dan Wesson, so that was cool. But he really liked the night guard, and he told me, he's like, I haven't really shot many revolvers. He's like, but this one just looks so tactical. He's like, it looks so tactical, man. Whatever. I guess he's like, it doesn't remind me of an old school revolver like, a cowboy would carry, or, like an old school cop or something. So I was like, oh, okay. And he's like, he was really impressed with the looks of the night guard, I guess. He really liked the sights too, so. But again, guys, this is the ammo I'm going to be using right here. This stuff, I don't know, just felt really good. You know what I'm wondering is the J-frame, when it came back to me from Smith, the laser seemed to be more dead on than the last time I took it to the range. I don't know if it's just me, but it was like dead on, the laser. So maybe, I don't know if the guys at Smith would adjust the laser or test fire. I mean, I don't know. And then they clean it up, who knows. But overall, Night Guard gets an A+. I had so much fun shooting it. It was a joy to shoot. Didn't even hurt. J-frame, on the other hand, it hurts, but it's a necessary evil to take the pain, because that's my primary CCW. And definitely, Night Guard's going to go on my hip when it permits. So anyways, guys, that's it for now. I'll be doing more videos about this stuff. Leave some comments and whatever, and I'll talk to you guys soon. So, as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.